What is good, friends? We got more World Cup coverage. We got Snowers, Duke Vesper, and he's on Team Italy. And Duke Vesper's on some US team, but I always mix them up. I'm not sure which exact team he is on. But he brings Ducktree, which can get rid of the Teeter in his matchup, and Merrick looking like a threat. Merrick, if it comes in on Skarmory, if he weakens the Landorus, it looks like a really big threat. We do see Tapu Fini. We saw one in the last game too. Interesting, because I don't think Fini's that good. Yeah, okay, so it's US Central. And this is obviously going to be Scarf Kelly from Snow's part. And if Duke Vesper is not Scarf Greninja, he's going to switch out here. Even if he's Scarf U-turn, I would not reveal it. I would play as if I'm not Scarf to make him lure into the situation where he thinks, where I can catch him off guard later on. If the Kelly is in range from the Greninja later on and he thinks it's not Scarf, he can kill with Gang Shot, something along those lines. I mean, he's obviously going to assume it's Scarf looking at the team. Scarf Greninja makes a lot of sense for Volcarona, unless he's Zardex, because Zardex is a decent Volcarona check, but he does reveal a Scarf turn 1. And yeah, Tapu Fini is coming out here. I mean, it's a good play in the sense, if the opponent switched out, you get momentum anyway. And he does go for Specs HP. Is that Specs? I think that's Specs. He goes for HP Electric turn 1. I thought he was Scarf. Tapu Fini. I think that has to be Specs. HP Electric does 30-36. So yeah, that has to be Specs. Choice Specs. And it does 46-54. Okay, it did 52. So yes. Just making sure. He's obviously not going to stay in here with the Kelly and take a Moonblast. He's going to go into those Tangrowths here. So if I'm Duke Vesper, I'm going to double out on the Tangrowths. Maybe not Charizard, depending on which Zard he is. I could see him being Zard X, because... Nah, he could also be Sashdag and have Stone Edge and that as a backup check for Volcarona. I mean, it's not the best Volcarona answer, but Scarf Grand plus Sashdag with Edge could kind of check Volk. Non-HP Ground variants get checked by Murek decently well, at least if it's healthy. But yeah, Volcarona is always a threat, like, no matter what in this meta game. Volcarona is insane. Those are the Landers. Predicting what? Oh my god, stop this, man. He went to Merrick predicting that. I don't know why he would go Merrick. I guess he predicted the Tangrowths, and Tangrowths wants minus speed nature. Tangrowths wants minus speed nature, right? So Merrick would be able to blow it away with a Flare Blitz or threaten it out. I would have to run the Kulk if Merrick can Oko Tangrowths, because otherwise this play was questionable, but I'm pretty sure it's able to Oko. Snow can just get up his rocks here. But yeah, I want to Kulk real quick if Merrick can Oko a Tangrowth with a Salt Wrath. Yeah, it can Oko with Flare Blitz. Yeah, okay. I mean, Fire Punch doesn't, but Flare Blitz Okos. And most of the Merricks run Rock Head, Flare Blitz, as he does just stay in with a great play. Picking him to go for Rocks, and that's an offensive Landorus, because that Shadowbone did 5 million. That Shadowbone did 5 million. Flare Blitz might have killed. Let's say, oh, you fly in on Z, Shadowbone. Take away the Intimidate. It does 74-88, so he either got a super high roll. Yeah, he got a high roll there. Flare Blitz might have even killed him. So maybe he is Lightning Rod then. If he didn't want to go for Flare Blitz. Never mind. What? Why does Flare Blitz do so little? Maybe I put the wrong item in. No, I put Cyclop. I'm really confused. But yeah, he does go for Z-move. It was pretty obvious that he's offensive Z-move Landorus from damage. Merrick gets blown away, and the Tapu Fini doesn't defog on this because it's slower. Actually, the Tapu Fini lives any one hit. Yeah, he can defog on it. But rocks have more PP than defog has, so you can basically keep up the rocks. I mean, Tapovini can taunt, but Elfkick's probably gonna 2-hit KO, so I don't think that does get. I don't think that gets Wesper anyway, going Feeny here. I don't know why Flabbers does less on his card. Oh, because I put Heatproof Landorus for some reason. My fault, guys. I just put a different ability than Intimidate. Okay, yeah, Flabbers would have killed. So I assume he doesn't have Flabbers. He either predicted the Kaleo, which is why Shady Bond over Flabbers, or he doesn't have it. Okay, he could have predicted the Kaleo. But yeah, he's either gonna go Greninja or Celesteela, I assume. Because you don't want to go Zard and take 50% from rocks. Going Doggy also doesn't get you anywhere, I don't think. So this is interesting. I think Snow has a Mega Tyranitar, and that's his way of checking. Like, he has Continental Crush slash if he uses Continental Crush, he still has Stone Edge, so Volcarona doesn't set up on Landris. That is one important point, because if he's not Scarf Kelly, he needs another way to check Volcarona. And Bulky Tyranitar is obviously a good way to check Volcarona, but it's usually paired with Ductrio, as you see. I mean, he doesn't have a Volcarona, but just in general, I'm like trying to break down Snow's team. I think Mega Tyranitar makes a lot of sense, because it can take on Volcarona. It's pretty bulky. But yeah, if it gets paired with Diarrhea, that doesn't really matter, because Tita gets trapped anyway. So, how you would have to play it versus Doggy is you would have to get up rocks. If they have Doggy plus Volk, so you can break the Doggy's Sash, then you have to DD up, and so Doggy can revenge you. I think Mega Tyranitar beats Doggy after DD, but I'm not 100% sure at the moment. But yeah, he's gonna go for Heavy Slam here, something like that. Some chip on the Assault Vest. I assume this is Assault Vest Tangrowth. This is pretty much a free knockoff for Snow. He doesn't lose anything from clicking knockoff. The only thing he would lose is the Tapu Fini coming in defogging. But that's not a big issue, because he just goes on the landers on a defog and gets the rocks back up. So yeah, that's fine. And I'm so tempted to eat, but I'm not gonna eat in my video. But I'm gonna drink a little bit. That should be okay, right? So he does reveal Leftover, so it's a most likely, oh man, I cannot talk English today. Probably Spadef Celesteela. I think Snow is pretty much in control of this game. Continental Crush was a cool play on the Marowak, because it kills the Marowak and it also covers the Celesteela switching in, which is why it was the play over Earthquaking. I can understand that. It also covers the Zard, but why would you go risk your Zard? So he's probably gonna be Scarf Tapu Lele on this team if he specs Keldeo. And I could see him having Rock Slide on Tangrowth maybe. I mean, yeah, he has Stone Edge or Z-Continental Crush on the Landris. He specs Kaleo, so Volcarona doesn't really set up on those two mons, and he has Mega Tita. So that's three mons that don't let Volcarona set up. So that might be enough, but if it's still not enough, he might also be Rock Slide on Tangrowth. But I assume it's gonna be the standard Earthquake, Hidden Power, Ice or Fire, and then Giga Drain slash Leaf Stone plus knockoff Tangrowth. He goes hard into Charizard, which is interesting, on a knockoff that was coming there for sure. And I assume he's gonna roost here. He might stay in regular form to not reveal which Zard he is. And if Tangrowth doesn't have Rock Slide, roosting here is completely fine. I mean, I guess he can Earthquake predicting the roost. He can Earthquake predicting the roost, but I don't think he was gonna risk that. Yeah, he was not gonna risk that, because this Tangrowth is really nice for the Tapu Fini, and also it's nice pretty much with everything. It can knock off Celesteela's leftovers, it can be annoying for the Greninja if the Greninja is locked into the wrong move. And yeah, Specs Kelly was a good play there. And now he basically gets a kill. I think Hydro Pump would easily 2-hit KO the Tapu Fini. I don't know if Scald would 2-hit KO the Tapu Fini, but we're gonna calc that real quick. Kelly choice Specs versus Tapu Fini. Skull does 22 to 26. So with rocks up, Skull is gonna 2-hit Gyota Tapu Fini, so he can click Skull freely. He doesn't lose anything. He doesn't have to risk a Hydro Pump. And if this is a ZY, I guess it's the only reason why you would Hydro Pump here if it's a ZY. Because a ZY is gonna be able to take a Skull. Skull does 57 to 68, and Hydro Pump would be a roll to kill the Zard, but it would be in Snow's favor to kill. So I guess Hydro Pump is overall the better play, but you risk missing. Yeah, I assume it's gonna be ZY. Like, just most of the time. It's not only because you don't really see ZX much. The combination of Ductrio, I just see it with ZY all the time. But yeah, it goes Hard Greninja breaking his Skull, or Hydro Pump, and there's the Hydro Pump miss. Which is... I agree with Hydro Pumping there, but the miss obviously sucks. If this Greninja doesn't have extra sensory, I don't really know how he's gonna kill this. On Scarf Greninja, it's gonna be U-turn, Rock Slide. Then it's either one special move, either Ice Beam or Hydro Pump. In the last slot, either Gang Shot or Low Kick. Yeah, probably Gang Shot, yeah. And he does get a crit, so that sucks a lot. That does suck a lot, as my man Dennis says, of course. He does miss the Hydro Pump. The Hydro Pump would have done a lot to Greninja. It would have done 69 to 81. It wouldn't have killed, but it would have brought this down super low. And Gang Shot would have done 54 to 64. That's Life Orb. It's not Life Orb, Greninja. It would have done 41 to 49. So I assume this is a physical attacking Greninja. Because a crit otherwise wouldn't have killed. Yeah, a crit wouldn't have killed. I assume this is going to be a max attack Greninja. This Gang Shot does 80 to 94 with a crit. Yeah, I assume this is a mixed attack. Maybe not mixed attack, but it has a lot of attack investment. It could still be some mixed attacking investment. Maybe only like 200 EVs in attack and some in special attack. But you turn Gang Shot, Rock Slide, and then maybe Low Kick or a special move, yeah. You can still run Hydro Pump or Ice Beam without special attack investment, even if you're completely physical based. But yeah, he's got a Mega Evolve with his Teeter here. He knows this is locked into Gang Shot, so he cannot go for low kick if he has it. And yeah, if he has Pursuit, he can go for Pursuit. He can go for Dragon Dance. He can go for Dragon Dance and pretty much win this game. It's a Mega Charizard. This is a dangerous Pokemon. So if he goes for Dragon Dance here and the Saddle Stealer comes out, how much is that gonna take? Tyranitar, Mega. I assume he's just gonna click that Dragon Dance button. You can also just click Stone Edge. But yeah, a plus one, let's say he's plus one. Let's say he's max attack, Jolly or Hardy, doesn't really matter. I can just put Jolly in there. And let's put Fire Punch in there. Fire Punch at plus one versus Spidef Celesteela, that is 70 to 83. And how much does Heavy Slam do? Heavy Slam does only 35 to 42, so that's an absolute snack. So Mega Tyranitar can Dragon Dance twice here and just win the game, I think. Because if it Dragon Dances twice, it should outspeed the Scarf Greninja, right? The max speed that Scarf Greninja can hit is, let me see, 377 times 1.5. Yeah, I assume he's just gonna DD on a Celesteela switch. The max speed Greninja can hit is 565. And if Tyranitar Dragon Dances twice, there's the Fire Punch. I think I would have DD'd again, maybe. He could have DD'd twice more and then just swept. I think he could have DD'd twice more and then just 6-0'd from there. With the Teeter. I mean, not 6-0'd, but like one with the Teeter. Soloed, swept. Yeah, that's the real question. Why didn't he DD again? So the Greninja hit 565. And Tyranitar does hit. The Tyranitar hits 530. He would still get revenged by Scarf. He would still get revenged by the Greninja plus 2, so he would have to DD two more times, which is why I understand not DDing again there. Yeah, I completely understand that play. Never mind. That play makes sense. Yeah, he gets revenged anyway by the Greninja, if I calc that correct. Greninja should be faster than plus 2 Megatar. Scarf Greninja, that is. And he should outspeed Dagaya plus one, so he's forced into Greninja here and click low kick if he has it. Which gives Tapu Lele a free switch in afterwards. He can also go, he can just go into Tangrowth to scout. He's not gonna gunk shot a plus one Tita. He's not gonna do that. He can go into something to scout like Skarmory too if he doesn't want to risk his Tangrowth, but Tangrowth lives any hit, like even if he goes for a gunk shot for some reason. Tangrowth is a fine play. He has regenerated, can scout what it locks himself into. Yeah, that's the best play I feel. Just going Tangrowth here. I mean, you lose the Dragon Dance boost, which is annoying because Tita comes in on Dagi. If Dagi comes in on Tita later on and you don't have a DD, you get revenge, but I don't think it should matter. Snow should have this game at this point. Because Escarvan is really good in some games, but like, if he locks into the wrong move, it just gives some mons free switch ins or setup. He does go for U-turn and it's not gonna kill, and this Tita might. Oof, it gets another kill here. Yeah, this game is over. I think he might have had to U-turn that, banking on the snow switching. But I think staying in was an okay play, because if he kills you with a low kick, I don't think he even has low kick. But yeah, that was Duke Vesper's only play if he doesn't have low kick. Yeah, never mind. Yeah, he had to U-turn twice to kill this. But even if he low kicked to Oko the T-Tar, he could have gotten a free switch in into Tapu Lele afterwards, or into anything. Those four mons got a free switch in, and if he had Scoundry, he could have gone for Whirlwind if he has Whirlwind, predicting the Zard from coming out hard. Or if the Zard comes out, it has to take rocks. He could have also gone Tapu Lele, yeah. But like I said, I think he Scarf Lily, so. Yeah, Scarf Lily also got a kill pretty much if it clicked Moonblast. Slash even Psychic. Doesn't really matter. Moonblast should 2-hit kill over the Zard after Rocks easily. So yeah, Tapu Lily basically got a kill if he had low kick to kill this. Doesn't really matter at this point. And Megatita is showing why it's not a bad Pokemon. It did win for. It was on a team that Porsche had in Smogto semifinals and it did win. I don't remember how much work it did, but here it did some work for sure. That's so cool to see Megatita put in work. Like, I got two kills already. That duck trio got blown away. I can understand why they're taking so long, because I think this is Vesper's first World Cup and I know him a little bit, so this sucks a lot that he loses the first game. But on the other side, it's a cool team from Snow's side. And Snow is also, I also know Snow a little bit, so it's hard who I'm rooting for. I'm just glad that we see a cool game here. Like, seeing Megatita shine in World Cup, who would have expected that, right? I mean, two kills is pretty much, I would call that put in work if you get two kills. Megatita is definitely a cool one, I want to build with it. I like it a lot with Tapu Bulu. And with Celesteela, I have like a team with these three mons, but I didn't finish building it yet. But he gunk shots there. I don't know if that would have killed the Tyranitar. But this gives a free switch in the Skarmory. Tita might just live a gunk shot. 16 to 19, and it's minus one. Or it's life orb, let me put in. Choice Scarf. And max attack, and then minus one in attack. Yeah, the Tita can come in here, or the Skarmory can come in. Tangrowth also lives one, obviously, but I think Tita's at 70%. It's not gonna do much at this, other than living a gunk shot at this point. So yeah, that's a good play, and he can go for Stone Edge and claim another kill. As long as Stone Edge connects, he gets another kill with this. I mean, maybe U-turn was the play, but like, U-turn let Lily in. Yeah, he had to bank on a choke, I think, yeah. Yeah, Vesper had to bank on a choke, and Snow was not gonna choke. Let me close my calculator, this is annoying. Yeah, my recording program is in the way, I can't close it, never mind. He asked if Fini eats to Moonblast. I'm pretty sure Fini doesn't eat to Moonblast after Rocks. Nah, it doesn't. It's at 42 after Rocks, dude. Yeah. Like, Psychic or Moonblast from Lele easily 2 hit KOs from there. Yeah, Vesper had to bank on a choke there, like I said. I don't know why I'm repeating myself. So he basically had to predict the hard tap with Lele or hard Tangrowth. I don't really know. I mean, you just click Stone Edge here if you snow, because it should kill the Tapu Fini. I don't think there's a point in running a call. It's a Mega Tita. This mon is not weak. After Rocks and Sand, it should kill the Tapu Fini. And the other two mons obviously die, because Greninja's frail and Zard is 4 times weak to it. So that's no doubt in my mind that the other two mons will die. He said he clicked, but it doesn't work. It didn't work? Okay, yeah, Snow still didn't pick. So yeah, the Tapu Fini has to dodge here, so Vesper still has a slight chance, but he didn't dodge and it gets that crit didn't matter, I don't think. He can calc real quick. Like, I don't know which Tapu Fini spread he has, I'm just gonna use the one in the calculator, right? I mean, his win condition pretty much now is going to Charizard and clicking Dragon Dance multiple times and dodging a few Stone Edges. I think that's his win condition. Stone Edge. At neutral. Not versus Greninja, versus Tapu Fini. This 49 to 50. Oh my lord, Tita is strong as fuck. Okay, that's offensive Tapu Fini. But it still should have killed, even if the Fini had some defense and West. I thought it was a Mega Tap early on. Yeah. I mean, it makes a lot of sense looking that like this team is kind of weak to Volcarona. This team appreciates the extra bulk that Mega Tyranitar brings over regular Tyranitar. But yeah, he can U-turn here. That doesn't really do anything though. Tapu Lele just... I mean, if it's that why, it's kind of a 50-50 between Moonblast and Psychic, because Psychic doesn't kill... Moonblast doesn't kill that why, Psychic lets in Greninja if he U-turns here and then Lele comes out. So if Duke Vesper plays perfect, maybe he can still has a slight chance. We will see. So let me just think this through. He goes for U-turn, picks off this. Oh, he goes for Gang Shot, okay. I don't think this kills. Oh, he gets the roll. Yeah, this was a roll. I think this was a roll. I did calc this earlier, right? Battle Spot has a choice card, we just said. Oh, it's level 50. Never mind. Yeah, Gangshot is 16 to 19, so he got the roll there. So he basically had to click that to not let the Lele in. I can understand. I understand that. But this now he gets the Skarmory, and if the Skarmory has Whirlwind, the Charizard is dead. Because he's forced into Charizard here. Unless he predicts the Whirlwind. If he predicts the Whirlwind, he's goat. I mean, it doesn't really change anything, right? Even if he predicts the Whirlwind and stays in. Then he is forced into Zard and he's forced to Roost. Yeah, he predicts the Whirlwind, because if he switches out... Oh, he stays in a Toxic. I mean, this is fine. Snow can just spam Toxic. Yeah, Snow wins this game. I mean, he would have to miss some moves. He would have to miss the Toxic here. And then this Zard. So what Vesper is basically trying to do is like sack his Greninja. He's sacking his Greninja. And then he's trying to set up with his Zard. Is like if he's even Zard X. I don't even know if he's DD Zard X. I thought he was Zard Y the entire time. But I'm just trying to see some way of how he can bring this back. Yeah, okay, if he's Zard Y, this is 100% over, I think, to Scarf Tapu Lele. Because if he goes Zard here and the poison hits, he's so low and he also can't Roost up. And Skarmory still has the Sturdy intact, his potential Whirlwind, like, this game is over. What did Dennis say? Shut the fuck up, what happened? Easily is not a real country and then he's getting mad. Good lord. He does connect the Toxic as Vesper realizes it doesn't really do anything for him to stay in. Really nice play on Snow to just keep spamming Toxic. Stays patient, doesn't make the wrong, like makes the correct play basically. Like if he roosts here and the rocks just put in so much work. If there was no rocks, this would have been different, maybe. Let me think. Tennis is playing later for World Cup. Didn't he play this morning? Was his mount? Like, see, if you Ruthie and the Scumrians will win, you're just in a bad position because you'd come back in at 25. And if you Ruthie and he switches out, it's still fine. It's still fine for Snow because there's poison damage on Azard. I think you just spams. He might just spam Earthquake here with his Tangrowth. So the Azard can't Ruthie more. That Olko's clean and Double Lily is gonna pick this out with Psychic, so this game is over, yeah. I didn't realize Toxic would bring it down that low. Toxic bring it down that low really clutched it out. So that means Psychic should definitely kill, right? Choice Scarf versus Charizard. I don't know if he's a bulky Zard. Yeah, Psychic does 66% if it's offensive Zard Y. And yeah, definitely picks up the win. And Greninja can't lock into move that kills the Lily and the... It has to click Gunshot to kill Lily. Greninja also changes its typing. So he has to go for the freeze. Freeze is his win con, but I think you can't freeze in the sun. I think that's how the mechanics work. He didn't even have to switch out there. He was completely fine because the Greninja obviously changes the typing. Unless the Greninja had Dark Pulse. If the Greninja had Dark Pulse, he actually still had a shot, maybe. Yeah, maybe. With Dark Pulse and then flinching the Skarmory. Snow picks up the win over Duke Whisper. Definitely deserved, man, but... Well, Megatar's beast, dude. I really want to build a Megatar, but I kind of struggle building around that specific mon. Because I like to use Firewater, Grass, Dragon, Fairy, Steel, Cores. And I couldn't really find one that works well with Megatar on the same squad and not being weak to like some certain mons that are way too common in OU like Greninja. I mean, actually, I'm not going to go into team building. Because this is like, I think the fourth World Cup game that I recorded today. Maybe it's even the fifth because I recorded one replay. So I got a lot of work to do. I gotta make some thumbnails now for those videos. Thank you guys for watching. And if there's more World Cup, I'll keep my eyes open and hopefully catch more for you guys. Peace out, friends.